Health Matters. The program that looks at latest news, analysis, and interviews about various health issues important to you. Only on 105.3 Afro FM, your infotainment station.
For Ayota Fari, life used to be good. She had a good marriage with a one-year-old son until she got into obstructed labor to give birth to her second child. Ayehu is one of the thousands of women in Ethiopia with fistula problems.
I went into labor for a week, maybe even more than a week. The baby died in my womb. Prior to my fistula problem, I was living with my husband. When I got this problem, my husband left me and got married to another woman. My life was limited to a small shed, waiting for food to be thrown in my direction. My life had become a life of isolation and shame because I can't socialize because of the terrible urine smell soaking my clothes.
لزلالم چهن ونا یه مدان حالون لساین بکندولم میگو بینین مرکامون مآزاب مسکانا
Fistula is a serious problem in Ethiopia. Pregnant women customarily deliver at home with only a female elder in attendance. The closest skilled doctor may be hundreds of miles away. Founded by Dr. Reginald and Catherine Hamlin in 1974, the Addis Ababa Fistula Hospital provides care for women with obstetric fistula, which is the most devastating of all childbirth injuries. The hospital provides free fistula repair surgery to approximately 2,500 women every year. It also cares for 50 long-term patients. It is the only hospital of its kind in the world dedicated exclusively to women with obstetric fistula. The Ethiopian government recently graced Dr. Catherine Hamlin with an award and honorary citizenship for her long service to Ethiopia. She explains about fistula and the contrasting treatment situations between developed and developing nations like Ethiopia.
A fistula is just an opening between an internal organ and the outside of the body. This is caused by long obstructed labor, and 5% of all women in the world get into obstructed labor. You can get a cesarean section done easily or some other skilled intervention to prevent the fistula. But in our country of Ethiopia, this is not available in the countryside.
In addition to incontinence, a fistula victim may also have nerve damage affecting their ankles and feet. If a woman lies on her mat for a prolonged period of time, waiting for the urine to dry, she may also develop contractions of the joints of her legs as her muscles and tendons shorten from lack of use and be unable to walk. Fistula victims also suffer profound psychological trauma resulting from their utter loss of status and dignity. Ayew had such devastating feeling of isolation and shame even from her husband. 17-year-old Wubit also shares the problem of isolation among her community.
I used to feel very insecure and sad about my condition, and I would cry when I would see my friends working when I could not. I decided to leave my village. I was really sad about my condition.
The village women think they've got some disease, and they sit on the buses sometimes coming down to our hospital with a tin under their bottoms, hoping that nobody will notice that the urine's dripping onto the floor around them. She becomes a social outcast mostly from her own will. She doesn't want to mix with her village society, and they don't want to mix with her because she's smelling, and there's nothing that they can do. So they're soaked in urine day and night, and they have terrible problems. And so they hide away.
The hospital is home to women like Ayo and Wubit. Wubit is happy that she came to the hospital. She says she is most relieved because no one in the hospital is disgusted with her fistula problem as in her hometown.
There is no one covering their nose when they see us. The hospital is clean and they take good care of us. There's nothing like this back home in the countryside.
The hospital also provides training for health professionals, for Ethiopian surgeons and obstetricians and gynecologists from all over the developing world. The hospital also carries out research in fistula-related topics. A few years ago, it has launched a midwifery training school to present a permanent solution to the dire need of skilled professionals to attend birth in rural Ethiopia and help prevent the occurrence of fistula.
We've been showing up women year after year after year, but we really have not done enough to prevent, or done nothing to prevent fistulas. We thought we must do something really which will cause a difference. So we set up a midwifery college to train midwives, taking the midwives from their rural environment, their 12th grade students from the high schools, but from the countryside, not from Addis Ababa. They belong to the communities that they're sent back to, and they work in the health centres with the government health centres, and this is what we hope will be a means of preventing fistula.
Some of the women who have been cured of the problem are now trained and work at the hospital.
Many of them have stayed on as workers in our hospital, and this is a very good way to run a fistula hospital because they can welcome the patients because they've been through the experience themselves. It's a thing that you can bring back joy to a woman's life.
According to information from the hospital in Ethiopia, where about 2.9 million women give birth a year, about 9,000 mothers will develop obstetric fistula. Obstetric fistula can almost always be prevented. However, prevention depends as much on social change as on medical interventions. Dr. Hamlin says prevention must be reducing the incidence of few injuries by focusing more on interventions that prevent maternal mortality and morbidity. The patients at the Fistula Hospital are provided with literacy and other crafting skills. They are also trained on self-improvement and entrepreneurial skills. At the end of the treatment, they are given a new dress and go back home to start fresh. After going back to their villages, they become advocates for maternal health and fistula.
Because they are going home, they are being sent off in style with new dress. I feel happy that I'll be home soon.